Greetings to everyone. In this video, I'm talking about the types of electrodes. Electrode is a metal conductor which conducts electricity. And basically, electrodes are classified into three categories: reference electrode, indicator electrode, and ion selective electrode. As our syllabus covered the reference electrode and ion selective electrodes, I'm going to cover those two topics in this video. Indicator electrodes, you will be familiar in lab. We will discuss about the indicator electrodes in the lab during the experiments. Reference electrode. It is an electrode with a standard electrode potential, which is constant. And with the help of the reference electrode, we can even identify any other metal electrode's potential. The electrode with constant electrode potential is referred as reference electrode. And reference electrodes are basically classified into two categories, primary and secondary. The primary reference electrode is the one which is the standard hydrogen electrode, whose potential value is considered as 0 volts at standard conditions. And we need to maintain 1 molar HCl concentration and 1 atmospheric hydrogen gas. Under that conditions, its potential is considered as 0 and it is considered as a primary reference electrode. And during the utilization of this electrode, it is not so easy to maintain the 1 molar concentration of HCl or 1 atmospheric pressure of the hydrogen gas. So we can't use this primary reference electrode to determine any other electrode's potentials under different conditions. So we are using the secondary reference electrodes with the calomel electrode is a secondary reference electrode. Silver chloride is a secondary reference electrodes. And by using these electrodes, we can identify any other electrodes potentials. But these electrodes potentials are calculated with reference to the primary reference electrode. Let's discuss about the secondary reference electrode, that is calomel electrode. So as I mentioned, it is a secondary reference electrode and its potential is determined by connecting it with the hydrogen electrode. And one must first understand its construction and then we'll move on to the reaction part and its potential values. If you can observe, it is a glass tube with an inlet here. This inlet is to add the KCl solution whenever required. And here at the bottom, we have Hg solid. And above that, we have a paste of mercury and mercurous chloride. And this total tube is filled with the KCl solution of various concentrations. And generally, we prefer saturated KCl solution. And we have a platinum wire here, connected with the silver chloride, and these are all sealed in a glass tube, and we will have another inlet. We can use this as a salt bridge to make an electrical contact with the electrolytic solution with other electrode. We use this salt bridge. Even a few of the calomel electrodes that we use in lab, we don't have this one, but generally we do have this also. Here the cell notation can be given as KCl of whatever the concentration we used. As I mentioned, we generally prefer saturated. We can represent this in the bracket as saturated. And we have mercury, mercurous chloride, and there is a platinum electrode. So the cell notation, the calomel cells, the calomel electrode can be represented as this KCl, its concentration, HgCl2/Hg and platinum. And here generally the calomel electrode in most of the cases can act as a cathode. And so that the reaction, whenever you have to write, you can write the reduction reaction only. That the reduction of mercury is chloride. Mercury. So if you can write the reaction, you can observe that we will get a product that is Cl minus from Hg to Cl2. So the Cl minus, if you can apply the Nernst equation, you know the Nernst equation, EMF of the cell is equal to E naught of the cell minus 0.0591 by N log of products by reactants. Here the reactant, which is mercury, is a solid, so we ignore that concentration. And then we consider only Cl minus. So the overall Nernst equation, what we get here is E is equal to E naught of Cl minus minus 0.0591 by N log of concentration of chloride ions. So this Nernst equation indicates us that the potential of this calomel electrode depends on the concentration of Cl minus ions. That's why I mentioned we can use various types, different concentrations of KCl solution. And depending on that concentration, the potential values vary accordingly. If we take saturated KCl solution, its potential is 0.2422. And if you take one normal KCl solution, it is 0.2820. And if we took 0.1N KCl solution, it is 0.3335 volts. It just varies with the concentration of KCl solution, but for a particular KCl solution, its potential value is constant. So as we generally prefer saturated KCl, and for our further discussion, we take this value, its potential as 0.2422. And there are a lot of applications with the calomel electrode. As I mentioned, we can determine any other electrode's potential values. And apart from that, we can even determine the concentration of H plus ions. Nothing but even we can determine the pH by using this calomel electrode by connecting it with the standard hydrogen electrode. So if you connect the standard hydrogen electrode with the calomel electrode, standard hydrogen electrode can act as an anode and the calomel electrode can act as cathode. So we know that EMF of a cell is equal to E cathode minus E anode. Your cathode is SCE, which is a standard calomel electrode. So ESCE minus standard hydrogen electrode. So we know that this standard hydrogen electrode's potential E naught of this is zero. So it becomes minus 0.0591 pH. We're ignoring E naught because its value is zero. So what we'll get is E cell is equal to ESCE minus zero, minus of minus 0.0591 pH. And this SCE value, as I told, if we use the saturated KCl solution, it is 0.2422. So you will get EMF of the cell is equal to 0.2422 minus of minus 0.0591 pH. And from that pH can be calculated as EMF of a cell minus the ESCE, that is 0.02422. divided by the 0.0591. So what you'll get is this equation, that is pH is equal to EMF of cell minus minus 0.2422 by 0.0591. Means you will know the EMF of the cell from the experiment. And once you know the EMF of the cell, you can able to calculate the unknown solution's concentration also, even pH also. And that is applicable for the acid solutions. There's a major application of the calomel electrode. So another type of electrode is ion selective electrode. These ion selective electrodes can respond to only a certain specific ions, and the potential that developed in that particular electrode is with reference to a particular species only, and it just ignores all other ions which are present in the electrolytic solution. Such type of electrodes are called as ion selective electrodes. They'll be developing their potential with respect to the presence of only a particular ion in the electrolytic solution. The glass electrode is one type of ion selective electrode, and this is a universally accepted ion selective electrode for pH determination. So if you can look at the structure, we just have a glass membrane here, and this glass have a low melting point, a high electrical conductivity, and it is made up of a specific material whose composition is silica of 72% and calcium oxide is of 6%, Na2O is of 22%. This membrane can be used in the glass electrode, and this thin glass bulb is filled with 0.1 NHCl solution inside, and we have a silver chloride coated silver rod inside the glass bulb which acts as an internal reference electrode. So this electrode can be represented as, we have silver, so Ag, AgCl, Ag slash AgCl, and we have an electrolyte, internal electrolyte solution, which is HCl of a specific concentration. You can mention its concentration in brackets, that is 0.1 m slash Gras. So Ag slash AgCl, and you can represent here solid, and then HCl electrolyte, in brackets you can represent the concentration slash glass. There's the cell notation for glass electrode. The major principle in the glass electrode is, you can look at this image. Here, as I told, we have a glass membrane, and inside we have 0.1 molar HCl solution. And for suppose, imagine that this glass electrode is dipped in a unknown solution whose concentration is not same as the internal solution. Then inside the solution we have a particular concentration, and outside solution has a particular solution concentration. So obviously there will be an accumulation of H plus ions in the hydrated gel, which is there above and below the glass membrane. There are number of H plus ions accumulated in this hydrated gel, and number of ions from this external electrolyte will be accumulated over here. So there will be some potential differences arises because of the difference in the concentration of H plus ions inside and outside, and that potential difference is considered as the boundary potential. And in order to maintain this potential difference equilibrium, there will be movement of Na plus ions from the membrane to the hydrated gel. So it's the movement of the ions into the hydrated gel to maintain an equilibrium potential between the inside and outside the solution. The hydrated gel membrane is connected by the Na plus transport, and thus the concentration of H plus ions inside and outside will be maintained in equilibrium, and that can be represented as here like this. We have a membrane with Na plus ions and plus H plus ions, and there will be movement of H plus ions and Na plus ions into the hydrated gel in order to maintain the concentration of H plus and at equilibrium. So the same thing here I just mentioned, this is a glass, imagine this is a glass, and this is an internal solution here, and we have a 10 nanometers thickness hydrated gel inside and outside, and here an unknown solution I took, and known concentration 0.1 molar HCl is there inside. As H plus ions concentration is not same inside and outside, there will be movement of Na plus ions either inside or outside in order to maintain the equilibrium concentration. That potential difference arises here is called boundary potential. And boundary potential can be represented as EB, which is given as a potential difference between inside and outside. And here I took internal as E1 with the concentration C2 and external as E2 and its concentration as C1. If you can write the Nernst equation for that, boundary potential can be given as RT by NF log of E2 by C1. And here C1 is constant, and which can be given as 0.1. And if you substitute that, you will get RT by NF log of 1 by 0.1 m, and that can be given as L here. So boundary potential can be represented as RT by NF ln and log of C2 minus L. So for the glass electrodes potential, we have to take the boundary potential into consideration. And you can remember, you can recollect that we have silver chloride electrode as an internal reference electrode, and that potential should also be considered here. And we took asymmetric potential also into consideration. So finally, the glass electrodes potential can be given as E glass electrodes, E naught of glass electrode minus 0.0591 pH. And the major advantages of this glass electrode is it is very convenient and simple to use, and it is not poisonous, and we can get accurate results in terms of even pH calculation or potential determination. And here no salt error is found when you use the glass electrode. And even we can be use this glass electrode though the solution is colored or turbid or colloidal. And even we don't require much quantities of the electrolyte. Even small quantity of an electrolyte is also enough to determine, to carry out our experiment. But there are some limitations also. It can't be used above 9 pH because it is very sensitive. It is not applicable for such type of alkaline solutions. Thank you. We'll discuss other topic in next video. Please do refer.